Hi everyone, my name is Glenn Bartley and welcome to the Peru edition of my video blog. I'll be down in Peru for the next 11 weeks trying to photograph as many species of birds as possible. And today's challenge is the endemic bearded mountaineer hummingbird. Now this bird likes to feed at these nicotina flowers that are right behind me. So I've set myself up here and I'm hoping to get a good shot. It'll be just one of the many adventures that I'll be up to over the next 11 weeks. So I hope you'll follow along. Thanks for watching.
It's about 5 in the morning and about to head off of our 3-week trek into Manu National Park, one of the most biologically diverse places on the planet. So it should be an amazing experience. We're going to visit lots of different elevations on the way down, and there should be lots and lots of birds to photograph.
All right, here I am on the world famous Manu Road, one of the most biologically diverse places on the planet. Just walking along the road trying to find birds. A lot of flocks moving around, amazing diversity of tanagers. We've seen a golden-headed quetzal, some different parrots, lots of hummingbirds, oropendulas. It's a pretty phenomenal place to bird. So, I'm just going to keep walking along, see what we see, and hope to get some good shots. We're still here along the Manu Road, and we're in an area of about 1400 meters elevation, and this is a place where there are tons of cock of the rocks, which is a spectacular orange bird. And right down below us here, they're at what's called a lek, where all the males are coming together to display. So I'll show you a video in a second of what that looks like, but yeah, it's a pretty amazing opportunity here to just be relaxing, sitting in a blind and watching these birds do their thing. One of the things that I absolutely love about being in the Amazonian lowlands are the noises at night.
all the frogs and insects making fantastic sounds. And just a few minutes ago, we had a really cool opportunity to photograph a rufescent screech owl, which was calling nearby. We heard it calling, and we're able to see where it was and get some really cool shots. So as soon as the sun goes down, that doesn't mean the camera goes away. There's always something to photograph here in the Amazon. All right, so we've moved on down the slope, further into Manu National Park, further into the jungle. Down here now, about 500 meters elevation, and this is truly the tropical rainforest. The forests are dense, they're thick, there's not a lot of light to work with, and photography can be really challenging down here. But the great thing about being down in the lowland forests here of Peru is that the diversity is mind-boggling. From this very site that I'm at right now, over 500 bird species have been recorded. Now, a lot of people think that when you come down here, you're going to see all kinds of different birds everywhere. There's a toucan, and there's a barbet, and there's a tanager. It's not really like that. The truth is that there's less of any individual species in an area. There's lots more different types of species, and you can see a lot of different things every day, but the fact of the matter is you're probably going to see less individual birds than you're used to back home. So I'm going to get back at it and try to photograph some more birds here, and I'll show you what we get in just a few minutes. We've moved even further down into Manu National Park now. We're down at about 300 meters elevation, moved well on down the river, and we're, this morning, it's about 5 a.m., we're headed off to a macaw clay lick where the macaws and parrots come to eat the clay to aid in their digestion. So it should be a spectacular sight, and I'll show you what that looks like in just a second. All right, here I am at the macaw clay lick. You can see behind me an area where a number of different species of parrots as well as red and green macaws come in to eat the clay, which they need to aid them in the digestion because the fruit that they eat is has the wrong pH or is too acidic for their body to digest naturally. So they have to come here every day and eat the clay. Now, right now it's a little bit drizzly and the birds are upstaging in the trees, but hopefully before long they're going to come down and start having a snack and we'll be able to get some great photos. It's a really pleasant place to just sit and watch the birds fly by. There's hundreds of parrots and probably about 60 macaws up in the trees. So pretty cool place to spend the morning. And like I said, hopefully we'll get some great shots. Wanted to talk to you a little bit about rainforest fashion. Now, it's very important when you're heading out into the jungle that you have the right fashion accessories, the right techniques here. So the first thing are the very stylish socks, pants tucked into socks. This is a good look, and it also protects you from bugs crawling up your legs. Second essential rainforest accessory is the sweet floppy hat. This will protect you from the sun. These are two important accessories. Don't leave home without them.
I'm out here in the forest, and I've just encountered a large army ant swarm. Now, this is a great opportunity for bird photography, because what happens is the ants swarm all through the forest. They go after everything they can find to eat. Spiders, scorpions, butterflies, moths, anything they can find, including my legs. They just raid through the forest, and anything is fair game. So all the bugs, all the other insects, try to get out of the way. What happens is there's a group of birds, mostly some of the ant birds and wood creepers and things like that, that follow the army ant swarms in order to get a pretty easy meal. So by positioning myself inside the swarm, even though I might have to get a few bites to do it, I can give myself a better chance at photographing some of these very hard to photograph birds. I'm going to get back at it. Okay, so I'm here at Pantiacoya Lodge in the Peruvian Amazon. I thought I'd give you a little bit of an idea of what one of these Amazonian lodges looks like. So let's go on inside. So here we have the main dining room where we eat our meals and relax. I've just got myself sprawled out here doing a little bit of writing and checking out some of the birds that might go after a little later on in the day. Got some coffee and fruit and things, little snacks over here. There's a bar over here, and some trail maps for figuring out where you're going to go. And if we just look back outside here, you can see a nice garden and some of the cabins off in the distance where we sleep and also where the washrooms are. So that'll give you a bit of an idea about what the lodges are like down here in the Amazon.
Okay, so believe it or not, I am still in Manu National Park. Been in here for about a little over 3 weeks now, but I'm in a very different ecosystem now. I've moved up the slope and I'm now birding at an area that is approximately 2,800 meters. Now that's one of the things that makes Manu National Park so amazing, is that the park covers an altitudinal gradient all the way from about 3,500 meters down to almost sea level, maybe 200 meters. And all along that transect are different birds. So right now I'm up in an area which is really what you'd call the cloud forest. Behind me are the lowlands, and every day that warm, moist air comes up. You might even be able to hear the wind right now. That's bringing the clouds up and creating this ecosystem here. So this is typified by plants that are covered by epiphytes and moss. This cool air comes in each day. Often it does bring clouds and rain, but it's a really, really spectacular place to be. And of course, being interested in birds, one of the things that makes this area so special are the mixed species flocks that are here. So some of the beauties that can be found in the flocks around here are birds like the scarlet-bellied mountain tanager, the hooded mountain tanager, grass green tanager, and a whole host of other beautiful species that hopefully I'll be able to photograph. So I'm gonna go get going on that. See you later.
Of course, no visit to Peru would be complete without a trip to Machu Picchu. It's a justifiably world-famous site. All in behind me here, it's just spectacular to come up here and see these ruins. We climbed up to the top of Huayna Picchu, which is the mountain you can see, or maybe not see because the clouds are coming back in. But yeah, it's a beautiful place to be, and I think it's a place that everyone should visit once in their lifetime. All right, up here almost at 5,000 meters in the central Andes of Peru. It's very high, it's quite cold, so as you can see, I've got myself a new hat. Keeps me nice and warm. We just found a critically endangered bird, the white-bellied cinclotis, and got some fantastic shots of it. And now we're gonna go walk down into this boggy area where another really amazing bird lives, the diademed sandpiper plover. So hopefully we'll find it and get some photos. Either way, it's an absolutely beautiful area to be, although very difficult to breathe.
Okay, so I'm up here at about 4,700 meters above sea level. Pretty high, pretty hard to breathe. Walking around, all behind me you can see is a bog. And this particular bog is home to a really special bird called the diademed sandpiper plover. It's a really beautiful little bird that I'm trying to photograph here. It lives near the water, in the creeks. I've seen them a few times and hopefully I'm gonna get some shots here. But regardless, it's a beautiful place to spend a morning.
Okay, Glenn.
All right, so today's lunch is trout, but first we have to catch them here. We have to work for our lunch today. We're looking for the big ones, though. It's like fly fishing. You have to kind of tease them a bit with it. Whoa.
Glenn, hurry up. I'm hungry.
I see a big one. Whoa.
Rápido tienes que sacar.
Oh, there's the big one.
I'm up a little
bit. Missed him.
You lost the worm, no?
Still got the worm.
Yes! Let's go!
Good job, man.
All right, here goes Doobie, round two of trout fishing. He's trying a different bait here. This time it's corn. Whoa!
Wow, man, that was my first fish ever. Too bad he's so small.
Yeah, you got a tiny one.
No, that's too small. That's not even enough for the sayuno.
All right, so just driving now in central Peru, just past the town of Junin, which is very close to Lago Junin. It's a famous birding spot, but we didn't stop there because we have a bigger target in mind. We're on our way to one of the most famous and somewhat hard to get to sites, which is Bosque Unchog. I'm here with my good friend Doobie, and we're traveling to Bosque Unchog to spend 3 days to try to photograph the golden-backed mountain tanager, which is one of the most beautiful species in all of Peru. So hopefully we'll have some success, and I'll check back with you from Bosque Unchog.
Yeah.
All right, so we've made it now to Bosque Unchog, which is one of the most spectacular birding destinations in all of Peru. Very remote area. We had to drive in on a very sketchy road to get here, and we're gonna have to sleep in the car for a few nights to be able to be here and photograph some spectacular species. Even this morning, we've already got the coppery medaltail, the pardusco, some beautiful tanagers, but the one we're looking for, the star of the show, is the golden-backed mountain tanager. We haven't seen it yet, but hopefully over the next couple days, we're gonna be able to get some shots. So here we are, it's the end of day three here at Bosque Unchog. It's been a fantastic 3 days, despite the cold and a lot of rain, sleeping in the back of a truck, really cold nights. But it's a very beautiful place, got a lot of really good shots here. Unfortunately, after 30 hours of hiking around, up and down, my legs are exhausted. we did not get the golden-backed mountain tanager. Not gonna lie, very disappointing. It's one of the most beautiful birds in Peru and really the star of the show here. But hey, sometimes you gotta leave some on the table, something to come back for another day, and hopefully another time we'll get that guy. So now, off into the north of Peru for another adventure.
What do you think of this weather, Doobie?
It's the end of the world. Everybody said it. 2012 is the end of the world.
It's 2011, bro.
Huh?
It's 2011.
But this is gonna go on for another year, man. There's no end to this. But I'm gonna have my last cookie ever.
Delicious.
Muy rico.
¿Te gusta el chocolate? Ya, este para ti. Un regalo para ti.
Wow.
So, driving around Peru for the last few months, been getting a lot of bad directions. We finally figured out why we never get where we need to get to. It's because we only ever get one answer for how to get there. De frente. Now, de frente means straight ahead, but no one ever tells you that you need to turn. So, we've kind of figured out the system a little bit though. De frente means just keep going straight ahead a little bit. De frente means you have to go a little bit further. De frente means, wow, you've still got a long ways to go. Let me show you what we mean here.
De frente. De frente.
No, de frente.
Okay.
De
frente.
De frente. Muchas gracias.
De frente.
De frente.
Muchas gracias.
De frente, la Panamericana Sur, de aquí, la norte.
De frente y ya doblas para allá.
¿Este?
Sí, de frente llegas a...
A Lima, de frente, no voy a ningún lado, de la frente nomás.
Okay, so we've made it now to northern Peru, up now in the famous Abra Patricia. We're at the Whiskered Owlet Lodge, a beautiful place. This wonderful canopy tower, which we're standing up in now. I was too excited yesterday to film a video because we were at the site of the marvelous spatula tail, and we got some fantastic shots of this probably most spectacular of all hummingbirds, which I'll show you before too long. Before I go any further, I should probably explain that it's currently November, which means Movember, which means it's mustache time, so excuse the facial hair. Anyways, we're here up in the north now, and we're gonna spend a few days birding around these beautiful forests, remnant forests. Most of the area around here has been cleared for agriculture and for fuel wood, but what does remain is spectacular, beautiful area, and hopefully we'll have some luck with some birds like the Royal Sun Angel, maybe even Cinnamon Screech Owl, and who knows what else. It's been a wonderful few days up here in northern Peru, here at the Whiskered Owlet Lodge. Just an insane day yesterday of photography. Started off with fantastic shots of undulated ant pitta. Later on in the afternoon, got an amazing opportunity with the Royal Sun Angel. And finished the day with definitely one of the encounters of my life as far as tropical birding, with the long-whiskered owlet that sat in front of us on a perfect branch 30 feet away for 15 minutes and just allowed us to photograph it to our heart's content. Pretty much one of the best days of tropical photography I've ever had. So, it's about time to leave the north via a few different dry forest habitats on the way back towards Lima. Going to stop in at Lomas de la Chai and hope for a few more shots there. Back to Lima for one night, and then back to home sweet home, Canada.
Is it really that much sweeter on the other end of that receiver? It's no need to convert a believer. I'm already yours.